Star 102.5's Ho 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 Show.
I am so excited. The day's finally here. It's our Ho 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 Show, and we've got O.A.R. and Neon Trees. And right now, I've got members of O.A.R. with me. Benj and Jerry, welcome to our little backstage area.
Ho Ho Ho.
I have to thank you guys. You made a special trip to Des Moines over the summer. You didn't even have a show here. But what you guys did was, on your way through, you wanted to meet some of our listeners. And it was early in the morning. I don't know if you remember. It was like 7:30, 8 o'clock. And you guys came in and gave us an incredible acoustic performance. A lot of bands wouldn't have done that. So I got to thank you for that. It was amazing.
Oh, it's our pleasure. And honestly, we don't mind getting up early anyway. I mean, I always find it funny that bands always complain. They're like, oh, it's so early. It's so early. Well, we're men, and we get up in the morning at a decent hour, and we go out, go to work. So to go and do a show at 8 a.m., not that big of a deal. We were glad to be here and glad we got to pass through and meet the audience.
I have to say, I could lie to you right now and pretty much tell you anything I thought you wanted to hear, but
well,
I'm
going
to be truthful. The Rockville LP is one of my favorite records of 2014.
Oh, it's so nice to hear. Thank you.
It is such a cohesive album, and every song on there to me could be a hit.
That's
because we're singing it nonstop at my house. We're singing it in the car. I'm hoping Two Hands Up is on the playlist for tonight. But I have to commend you. You guys did such a great job with it.
We really appreciate it. I think it's a labor of love for all of us, you know, and it's produced by our singer, Mark, and he worked so hard on it and the writing. I think everybody put, you know, everything they had into each little piece of it, you know, and that's what it takes to make a solid record. And after, you know, so many studio albums, you know, we're not leaving any stone unturned.
And with this record, you guys did kind of a behind-the-scenes little series of videos that you put up on your website, which I thought really explained a lot behind the music.
No, absolutely. We did a series called Home Movies, and what we did is we went back to Rockville, Maryland, and we went down the same streets the guys traveled on when they were growing up. We went down to Chris's basement where the band rehearsed. We went and saw what Black Rock really is. I was in the band 15, 20 years. I didn't even know what Black Rock was, so I got to go see that, and that was really cool. So basically, all those places that really charge our creative batteries and have really been the genesis for all of our creativity, you know, just being at home with the friends and the family, and what it was like at that time during our lives has really carried us through our career. And to go to do the Rockville LP, we were looking to write tunes and things, and the boys went back there and kind of recharged their creative batteries back in their hometown. And you know, out came the Rockville LP. So we wanted to show people that. We wanted to show a little bit of ourselves. And what I really love about it, it's not a performance piece. You don't see us on stage like you see most things talking about bands and things like that. There's barely any instruments in the darn thing. It's basically who we are, how we came up, where we came from. And I think people are really connected to that, and it really helped them understand the Rockville LP and where we came from.
For fans of the band, it was like a love letter back to them. Like, here's more about us. And I just thought that was a really nice touch. And you guys are very active on social media and with your fans, which I think
Absolutely.
Is a very cool touch.
Thank you. I mean, it's important right now, I think, in the way things are in music and in, I guess, the age of the internet. But we really have this connection with our audience where it's just the right thing to do. It's the way we feel that they're providing us this life, being able to continue being a band together. So, of course, we're going to stay in touch and have fun with it.
One of the things I hear over and over from people who, you know, I've heard your music on the radio, and then they go to see you live, that once they see you live, that fandom switch is, like, flipped, and it's like, now I have to go back and get everything they've ever done. And I think that's kind of a great thing for someone to see you live and think, holy cow, what am I missing out on? And that's, you guys are excellent on stage.
Well,
you just
you.
Rock it.
You know, I think for us, we started as a live band, you know, and we take so much pride in putting on a great show and having every person leave that experience feeling better than when they walked in those doors, you know, and that's the idea. And we go into every show like that, and that's what it's all about.
And you just did a little mini tour with Andy Grammer.
Love Andy.
We love Andy,
Andy's
too.
Andy's probably the nicest guy, one of the nicest guys in the world, and that guy is a worker. I'm in the venue pretty early every day. He beat me in the venue every day. He was working on tunes, did the gig. I mean, really, dude's a worker, deserves every ounce of success he has.
Absolutely.
Very fun musician. And we have to talk a little bit about, you know, what 2015 is going to hold for the band. I mean, you released the Rockville LP in June, doing a lot of live dates. So what's the next year lined up like?
I mean, right now we just released our second single, Favorite Song, mm-hmm. so we're going to continue to work on
I've heard that a few times.
Nice. Good. Yeah, thank you for supporting it by playing it. It means a lot to us. And I think, you know, there's other music that we're going to release as singles if all goes according to plan. We have another summer tour coming up and more stuff in the spring. I think there's a bunch of, like, one-offs in the winter dates, you know, some really cool things that are brewing for people to come out to that are kind of special shows. So I think we're just going to keep doing what we're doing and just try to provide really great experiences for our audience and whoever else might want to come.
We appreciate that. All right, it's our Ho 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 show, so let's talk just a minute about Christmas. Let's just reach inside, grab that inner child for a moment. I want to know, what was the one Christmas gift as a child you really wanted, but Santa didn't leave for you?
Oh, man. Let's see, the one thing, my folks, that's a great question. I mean, I think I was really lucky. One, I don't think I ever asked for the world in for Christmas, but like the things that I got, you know, I mean, were really integral moments in my life. One, the first time I got a Nintendo,
yeah.
I remember that. I was 11 years old. That was the last time I ever studied or did any real work. So, folks, parents, remember that. But I remember, like, my first rock and roll experience with my buddies. We said, we want to be in a band. No one knew how to play any instruments. So we all sat there with our friends. We sat there and we go, okay, you're going to play drums. I'll play bass. You're going to play guitar. And we'll all ask our folks for something for Christmas. And that's what we got. So I got a bass for Christmas, and the drummer had drums and stuff. So the 26th of December, we were in his basement just making noise and
oh,
a racket
cool.
and playing rock and roll.
How about you, Bench?
Well, I don't have anything that leads back to music. Mine were just things
that's
that
okay.
a child shouldn't have, probably, like guns and fireworks and just things that, like, in a suburban neighborhood don't go well with not getting arrested or anything like that.
Your parents gave you fireworks for
No, they
the
didn't. That was what I
That's
wanted.
What he wanted,
yes,
but
I was like,
well, it's understandable then that
yeah,
that was kind of
totally. Keep all those things away from me. All good.
I got to thank you guys for coming. Our Ho 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 show tonight is going to be kicking off with you guys. So I really encourage everyone to get here early. As I've said before, the Rockville LP, one of my favorite records of the year. Favorite song.
Thank
just
you.
It's
Thank
so well put together, and the pop culture references in there that Mark just intertwined them so well.
Nailed it.
He did a great job. He did nail it. So thank you so much for coming. Can't wait for the show tonight. And hopefully this isn't going to be the last we hear from you. I hope that, you know, if this summer tour
you
comes back around.
Word. We will come right back
Yeah,
here.
This summer tour, we expect Des Moines to be added to that.